Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding mode of disease transmission. Okay, we know that communicable diseases are not limited. It will spread from one person to another person, as well as it is not limited in a particular place. It will spread to different places. Right? So, mode of disease transmission means how a disease is transmitted from one person to another person, or the way by which a disease is transmitted from a person or anything to another person. Okay, a disease is transmitted from one person or a thing to another person is called mode of disease transmission. Okay, communicable disease will spread from a infected person to another person, or a infected thing. It may be animal, insect, or it may be soil or any other non-living thing, to a new person. He is not having any previous history of any infection. So the way by which the disease is transmitted from one person to another person is called mode of disease transmission. Okay, for example, tuberculosis. Okay, a TB patient is there, and while coughing or while spitting, that drops is getting by other person. He is also getting tuberculosis. Okay, so mode of disease transmission means the way by which the disease is transmitted from one person or a thing to another person. Okay, we can see the definition of the mode of disease transmission. Okay, the route by which an infectious agent is transmitted from a reservoir to another host. That is the definition of mode of disease transmission. That is the route by which an infectious agent may be a bacteria, virus, protozoa or fungus, for example. Okay, so infectious agent, the route by which an infectious agent is transmitted from a reservoir. The reservoir may be a infected person, that is a TB patient in this example. From a reservoir to another host. The host is the human being, the person who is receiving any infection. Got it? In this example, the infectious agent is bacteria, that is Mycobacterium tuberculi in tuberculosis. The reservoir is man, and the host is the person who is receiving that infection. Here the reservoir is the infected person, okay, TB patient, and the host is, he is not having the history of tuberculosis, he is receiving that bacteria from the reservoir, that is from the TB patient. Got it? That is the definition of mode of disease transmission. The route by which the infectious agent is transmitted from a reservoir to another host is called mode of disease transmission. The infectious agent is there, reservoir is there, and a host is there. The route by which route, through orally or any route. Okay, the route by which the infectious agent is transmitted, that is transported from a reservoir. Reservoir may be a human being or an animal or an insect or a non-living, for example, soil. Okay, reservoir means the place where the infectious agent live before reaching to the host. Okay, the place where the infectious agent live before reaching to the host, that is reservoir. Infectious agent is bacteria. The place where the bacteria, I am giving the example only, the place where the bacteria live, like a home, okay, before reaching to a new host, that is before reaching to a new human being. Okay, this infectious agent, that is the bacteria, is living in a TB patient and it is reaching to the host. This reservoir may be human being or animal, or it may be any non-living things also. The place where the infectious agent live before reaching to the host is called reservoir. Okay, so we can see our definition. The route by which the infectious agent transmitted from a reservoir to another host is called mode of disease transmission. Three things you have to keep it in mind: infectious agent, reservoir, and a host. That is the definition of mode of disease transmission. Next, we can see the types of disease transmission. Okay, how this transmission is occurring? Mainly two types you can see, that is direct transmission as well as indirect transmission. Disease can be transmitted directly as well as indirectly. Okay, so we can see regarding direct transmission. Direct transmission means person to person. Okay, from a human being to another human being, or from a infectious agent to a new host, without a intermediate, without a mediator. In between, a mediator will not be there. Directly the disease will transmit from one person to another person, or from a infectious agent to a new host. A intermediate or a mediator will not be there. For example, water or food or animal will not be there in between. A mediator is not there. Directly between a person to another person, or directly between an infectious agent to a person. Okay, a intermediate or a mediator is not there. Mediator in the sense soil or bedsheet or water or food or blood or any other biological products, that will not be there. Directly this transmission is occurring between person to person, or between the infectious agent to the host. Directly it is occurring, that is direct transmission. Okay, we can see one by one. First one is direct contact. Direct contact, contact between two persons directly. Okay, through touching. If a person is having any infection and that person is touching a common or a normal person who is not having the history of that infection, through that touch, it is a direct contact. That person is also getting the infection. Through touching, as well as through kissing, as well as through sexual contact. For example, STDs. That is HIV and hepatitis B. Okay, it is transmitted through sexual contact. Some kind of skin infections, eye infections are occurred through this direct contact between person to person. Okay, if a infected person is touching a normal person who is not having the history of any infection, or else this normal person is touching a infected person, or kissing a infected person, or having any sexual contact with this person, definitely that person will also get the infection. Got it? Or else from same person also infection will occur. That is, if you are having in your finger or in your nails a bacteria is there, and you are scratching your hand using that finger, you are scratching your skin. So from you only you are getting a infection. Okay, that is direct contact. Direct contact occur between the person as well as from the same person also. If a bacteria is there in my finger or in my nail and I am scratching my hand, okay, so from the same person, from me only I am getting the infection. Or else if other person is having that infection and that person is touching me, I am also getting the infection. That is direct contact. Direct contact occur through kissing, as well as through touching, as well as through sexual contact. Okay, next one is droplet infection. Droplet infection, that is through drops. From the name itself you can get an idea that droplet means through drops. That may be saliva or sputum or any secretions okay, through coughing as well as through sneezing as well as through spitting or speaking. For example, TB patient, it will occur through, it will spread through droplet, while coughing, while spitting, while speaking, as well as while sneezing also. If a person is in front of a TB patient and that TB patient is coughing or sneezing or spitting or speaking, that drops will go to the person and he will also get the TB infection. That is droplet. The drops may be saliva or the sputum or any other body secretions. For example, tuberculosis. Okay, next one is contact with soil. Contact with soil, that is in soil bacteria is there, virus is there, fungus is there and worms are there. We know the common infection among the children's, that is worm infections, right? So from the soil, if the human being is come in contact with this soil which have the infectious thing, directly contact with this soil also get a infection. For example, tetanus or hookworm infection, right? Directly the person is coming contact with this soil which have bacteria, virus or fungus or the worms, so that person is also getting infection. So contact with soil is also comes under direct transmission. Okay, in that soil the microorganisms will there and the human being is coming and a contact is occurring with this soil. Got it? That is contact with soil. Next one is inoculation into skin or mucosa. Inoculation means injection. Okay, this just like injecting only. Injection into the skin or mucosa. For example, if a nurse is giving injection to the HIV patient and a accidental prick, by mistake the nurse got a prick from that needle, from that syringe the nurse got a prick after giving injection to the HIV or hepatitis B patient, so definitely the nurse will also get that infection, HIV infection, right? That is inoculation into skin or mucosa. Next example is among the drug abusers, drug addicts. Okay, among the drug addicts, they will take the drugs through injection, and if a person is having HIV or hepatitis B, there another person will use the same syringe and he will also take the injection using same needle. That is also inoculation into the skin or mucosa. That is through the needles mainly this type of infection is occurring, that is through injection. Got it? Next one is transplacental or vertical. Transplacental or vertical, from the name itself it is transmitted through placenta. That means from a mother to the child, from a pregnant woman to the fetus. Okay, if the mother is having any infection, that infection is getting to the child also. For example, AIDS and HIV infection, through the placenta it is getting, that is transplacental. Through the placenta that infection is spreading. Okay, from pregnant woman to the fetus. Okay, that is from the mother to the child through placenta. It is also called vertical. Transplacental or vertical is also coming under direct transmission. Okay, next we can see indirect transmission. Indirect transmission is just opposite to direct transmission. In direct transmission we have seen that it will occur directly, but in indirect transmission a intermediate will be there in between this. okay, a intermediate will be there. It is not occurring directly, but the infection is occurring indirectly. In between that, a intermediate or a mediator will be there. A mediator will be there. For example, water, through water or through food. The infectious agent is there in the bacteria is there in the water, or bacteria is there in the food, or the virus is there in the blood. If the person is taking that water, or if the person is taking that food, or if the person is receiving that blood, or through the animals, from the rat, from the mosquito, as well as from the infectious bacteria or the virus is there in the bed sheet of the patient or pillow cover of the patient, that time also you can call it as a intermediate. It is not occurring directly. Indirectly, it is occurring. A intermediate or a mediator will be in between this. Okay, that is indirect transmission. We can see one by one. First one is vehicle borne. Okay, first one is vehicle borne, which include vehicle borne include water, food, blood, and biological products. Okay, I have already given the example. In vehicle borne, mainly water, food, blood, and biological product. If virus is there in the water, or virus is there in the food, or virus is there in the blood, and the biological products mainly organs. Okay, organs, that is kidney or heart as well as liver. During transplantation of the liver as well as the kidney, this type of infection will occur. If the donor is having such type of infection and person who is receiving that organs, he will get the infection. As well as while drinking a contaminated water or a contaminated food, or receiving a virus contained blood, will also get a chance to get the infection to the person who is receiving such things. So the intermediate is there. In vehicle borne, mainly water, food, as well as biological products and blood. Okay, next one is vector borne. Vector borne means the animals as well as the insects. For example, through mosquito. Mosquito is a mediator. From the mosquito, you are getting so many infection. For example, malaria, right? And the flies, cockroach. From the rat, you are getting, as well as from the bat, you are getting the infection. So in vector borne, mosquito, flies, cockroach, rat, and bat comes under vector borne transmission. From these animals as well as from these insects, from their bite as well as from their body fluid, there is a chance of getting infection. That is vector borne. Last one is fomite borne. Fomite borne, that is inanimate objects, that is the non-living objects. Okay, non-living objects other than water and food comes under fomite borne. For example, bed sheet of a patient, bed sheet of a infected patient. In that bed sheet, bacteria or any other microorganism is there. A doctor or a nurse is come in contact with that bed sheet, directly that nurse or the doctor will get the infection. Okay, so the intermediate is bed sheet, pillow cover, pen, water tap, the surgical dressings of the infectious patient. Okay, comes under fomite borne. So fomite borne means all the inanimate objects or the substances other than water and food. The main things are bed sheet, pillow cover, towel, pen, taps, and surgical dressing of the patient who is having the contaminated or the communicable disease. And if a common person, a normal person is coming in contact with these things, contact with the bed sheet or with the pillow cover or with the surgical dressing or touching the tap. Now COVID-19 is a good example for this, right? That's all regarding the modes of disease transmission. We'll meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.